to worry about.
Run, 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 but you sure can't hide. Thank you, son. This line may sound familiar to some. It is a line from the song titled Ball of Confusion, sung by the group The Temptations in 1970. I'm going to borrow this line as a title and subject for today. There are two scriptures from the Bible that I'm going to relate this to. Adam and Eve being the first to run, followed by Jonah. Turn with me, if you will, to Genesis 3rd chapter, 6th through 8th verse. And then we'll go to Jonah, 1st chapter, 1st through 3rd verse. I'll be reading from the New International Version. When the woman saw that the fruit of the tree was good for food and pleasing to the eye and also desirable for gaining wisdom, she took some and ate it. She also gave some to her husband who was with her and he ate it. Then the eyes of them both were opened and they realized they were naked. So they sewed fig leaves together and made coverings for themselves. Then the man and his wife heard the sound of the Lord God as he was walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And they hid from the Lord God among the trees of the garden. Now Jonah, the word of the Lord came to Jonah, son of Amittai, go to the great city of Nineveh and preach against it, because its wickedness has come up before me. But Jonah ran away from the Lord and headed for Tarshish. He went down to Joppa, where he found a ship bound for that port. After paying the fare, he went aboard and sailed for Tarshish to flee from the Lord. Now, these two scriptures are examples of two different types of running. In the example of Adam and his wife, they ran because of disobeying God and fear of punishment. Adam and Eve were the first to run from God. However, Adam had a purpose, a calling by God for a specific thing. His calling or purpose was to reveal godliness in this world, to elevate it to a higher level, a higher spiritual level. Adam, being the only man on earth, was the power to connect the physical with its spiritual source. He was a physical being with a soul. He and his wife chose to run after disobeying God and becoming aware of both good and evil for the first time and seeing themselves as naked. They both ran to hide from God. In spite of Adam's disobedience to God and receiving his punishment, God still had a plan and a purpose for Adam. He allowed Adam with Eve to produce children, which brought forth more life and generations and history. The name Eve was given to Adam's wife because she had a purpose also, which was to be the mother of all the living. Although Adam hid in the beginning, he could not run or hide from fulfilling his purpose on calling, and neither could Eve. Now Jonah tried to run from God. He tried to run from his calling, which was to deliver the message from God to the Ninevites. He ran in the opposite direction from where he was supposed to go. As the story goes on, Jonah gets on a ship running from God, as he thought he was. God causes the storm at sea. Jonah is thrown overboard to spare the lives of everyone on the ship. God allows a great fish to swallow up Jonah because he still had purpose. It wasn't his time to die yet. God gave him a second chance to fulfill his purpose or his calling by allowing the fish to spit him out. And he ended up going where God told him to go from the beginning and delivering the message that God wanted him to deliver. Jonah realized that God was with him, whether he was in disobedience or obedience. No matter how far he ran or how long he ran, God had a calling on Jonah, and he could not run or hide from that calling. Amen? What am I saying to you? If you have a calling on your life, my God, to preach, teach, sing, play a musical instrument, head a specific ministry, prophesy. My God, so forth and so on. You can try to run from that call, but you cannot hide. You cannot hide from God or that calling on your life. Amen? You can't run from that your call, gift, or purpose. We were all created by God for a specific purpose.
Thank you, Jesus.
God didn't place that calling on you to sit on it. It's for someone else. Someone somewhere needs to hear that sermon that God has for you to preach, or that prophecy to come forth from you, or that song sung by you to encourage them. I can personally speak that at a point in my life, when I needed to wait and hear from God, I needed to listen to God, it was through Yolanda Adams, "Be Still." And that encouraged me, and that told me that maybe I just needed to quiet time a little bit, be still a little bit, and hear from God. So I thank God that Yolanda Adams answered her call and is fulfilling her purpose. Think about this. What would have been like if Jesus had not fulfilled his purpose? My God, we would really be in trouble. We run for many different reasons. Some of those reasons are for fear of punishment because we have disobeyed God. We run away from our calling and purpose because we may feel inadequate, insecure, undeserving of being chosen by God. We run because we don't want to endure the trials of being chosen and the pressures and the sacrifices that go along with it. We run because we'd rather be in the background, behind the scenes, per se. We also run because we don't want to have to change any of our habits, behaviors, and attitudes. Sometimes we run because we just don't want to be held accountable. Therefore, we try to run by doing things contrary to God's will and purpose for our life. We purposely mess up with the intention of God getting God to change his mind about using and choosing us. We may cuss, smoke, drink, become involved in unhealthy relationships, lie, steal, deceive, not read or study God's word, slack in our prayer life, etc. These things are minor to God. The Bible tells us that he knows that we all have temptations. Romans 3:23 states, "For all have sinned and fall short